And today we're going to do G-tube medication administration. So we're going to verify that we have our patient's chart and our physician's order. Okay, so we have Jamie Jones, MRN number 589-135-1329, date of birth 1/16/62, and we want to verify that the patient has no known allergies. So today we're going to do the medication administration. So again, I'm going to compare the MAR with the physician orders. I have Jamie Jones, MR 589-135-1329, date of birth 1/16/62. The patient has no known allergies. The patient is currently MPO with medications per G-tube. I see today that the patient has morning medications due at 10 a.m. I'm going to now take my MAR and go to the med cart and prepare medications to administer to the patient. Now I'm going to do my hand hygiene. Okay, so we're going to perform our first check. Grab the patient medications here. I see this is Jamie Jones. Date of birth 1/16/62, MRN number 589-135-1329. Okay, I see here I have potassium elixir 20 MEQ daily per G tube, potassium chloride 20 MEQ per 30 mLs, expiration date 12/20/50. So we're good. Next medication, erythromycin 250. Capsule every 6 hours per G-tube, due at 10 a.m. Erythromycin here, 250 capsule every 6 hours, and I'm going to give this per G-tube. Next medication, Lopressor 50 milligrams per G-tube twice daily, due today at 10 a.m. Medication, Lopressor 50 milligram tablet. And that is it for our G-tube meds. So now I'm going to perform my second check. Again, I have erythromycin 250 milligram capsule every 6 hours per G-tube due at 10 a.m. Again, Lopressor 50 milligrams per G-tube twice daily due today at 10 a.m. And potassium chloride elixir 20 mL equivalents per daily per G-tube due today at 10 a.m. expiration date of 12/20/50. And I also checked the expiration date on my other medications and they are good to go. So now I'm going to prepare my medications. So I've completed now my first and second check along with my 6 writes. I will complete the documentation after I have administered the meds. Going to don my gloves. Okay, my first medication is the potassium elixir. I'm going to grab a med cup here. 20 MEQ, so it says here on the bottle 20 MEQs per 30 ml, so that means I'm going to need 30 mLs of this solution. Now each of your medications should have a separate medication cup. So now I'm going to measure this out. Okay, that's my potassium, 20 MEQs with 30 mLs. Okay, my next medication is erythromycin 250 capsule. Since this is a capsule, we can't crush it, but we're going to go ahead and open the capsule, put the powder inside of the med cup here. I'm going to open this capsule. And prior to doing all this, I did check all my medications. I know the reason and the side effects and any nursing implications that I might need to be concerned about prior to administering the medication. Patient's vitals were stable and labs were good for the morning. Okay, that's my erythromycin. Next, I have the Lopressor 50 milligrams for the G-tube. This medication, since it's a tablet, I'm going to have to crush. So you want to make sure that your pill crusher is clean, which it is, and then I'm going to have to clean it after use. I'm going to put the 50 milligram tablet in there. I'm going to crush it. Come on. Okay. The other option would to be to use this Silent Night here. Okay. I've got my medication all crushed. I'm going to put it in its med cup. Got to get it all in there. Okay. And then we need to make sure we clean it after we use it. So we're going to grab an alcohol wipe here. And I'm going to clean it. Get any... So when the next person comes to use it, it's all ready to go. Now I'm going to dilute my medications with about 15 mLs. Okay. I need to grab my piston and the container. We're going to put our medications here on the tray because we're going to go to the patient's room. I also am going to grab a tongue depressor. Okay. For my hand hygiene. Okay, now we're about to enter the patient's room. Knock, knock, knock. Hi, Mr. Jones, it's Sarah again. I'm here to administer your medications. How are you doing? Any pain? Okay, good. All right, I'm performing my hand hygiene. I'm going to don my gloves. Okay, then we want to make sure that the patient is positioned at a 45 to 90 degree angle. Okay, how's that? Is that okay for you? And then I'm going to bring it up to a comfortable height for me. Okay, Mr. Jones, can you verify your name and date of birth for me? Jamie Jones, we have here MR58913513329, and date of birth you said is 1-16-62. Great. Okay, any pain or abdominal discomfort? No? Okay, good. I'm just going to take a quick listen here. Okay, now we're going to check for tube placement. So we want to drop about 30 milliliters of air. Okay, we're going to put the tube into the patient's tube, or the piston into the patient's tube. Place the stethoscope over the patient. I'm going to instill the air. Listen for a swishing sound. Okay, sounds like placement's good. Now we want to aspirate for any content. Okay, anything less than 250 can be instilled back into the patient. Okay, remove my piston here. I'm going to close up the G-tube so nothing leaks out. All right, now we're going to get ready to administer a med. So let's make sure everything is fully diluted. Mix everything up here. So here's our Lopressor. This is for... your heart, I verify that your vitals are stable, so it's okay to give your erythromycin. That's here, that's an antibiotic. And your potassium. Your potassium was a little low today, so we're going to give you some of that, okay? All right, and that's already diluted in a liquid form. Now I'm going to take the piston out again. I'm going to take the plunger out. We're going to put the syringe back into the patient's G-tube here. We're going to administer about a 15 milliliter flush. I made sure that I have enough water in the graduate for each flush. Okay, so there's about 15 mLs. Okay, flush, make sure there's no clogs or anything. Now we're going to administer a medication. So first here I have the Lopressor. And after each medication, you're going to flush as well. So another 15 mLs of flush. Here's some water. Okay, good, let that clear. Then our next medication, the antibiotic. Okay, and another 15 ml flush. And lastly, the potassium. And last, you're going to do a 15 to 30 ml flush after the last medication. Okay, good. Then remove the piston. Close up the G-tube. Okay, Mr. Jones, I've given you all your medications. Is there anything else I can do for you right now? Put my side rail back up. The patient has its call light. I'm going to lower the bed. Remove my gloves. Perform my hand hygiene. Okay, Mr. Jones, I'm going to go document what I did right now. You let me know if you need anything. I'll be back in about an hour to check on you. Now I'm back at the nurse's station. I'm going to document. We want to document right patient, right medication, right dose, right route, right time, and correct documentation. I also want to document how much fluid I gave the patient during the medication administration and that he tolerated the procedure well. I also resumed tube feedings prior to leaving the room per the physician orders. And that concludes our G-tube medication administration skill for the day.